How do you build the world's tiniest skyscraper? Layer by layer, of course. Chips consist of billions of transistors and many layers of circuitry. It's basically a tiny skyscraper with 100 or so floors. To be a fully functioning building, you better make sure that all of the plumbing, the stairs, and the elevator shafts are lined up perfectly. The same goes for a chip. That's why we build it layer by layer. We're going to start with the foundations. Joep?
Yes. First, depending on what we want the chip to do, a bare silicon wafer gets a thin film of conducting, isolating, or semiconducting material deposited on it. Next, we cover the wafer with a light-sensitive coating known as photoresist. This will allow us to start building structures. Next, the wafer goes into a photolithography machine. That's us! Our machines use ultraviolet light to quickly and precisely print the 2D pattern of one chip layer onto the wafer. The pattern is printed on each part of the wafer that will become a chip. Shorter wavelengths mean sharper resolution and smaller patterns. Our latest lithography machines have a resolution of just 8 nanometers, enabling the tiniest patterns ever printed. In etching, excess material is chemically washed away to reveal the intended 3D pattern. This pattern will become part of the integrated circuitry. Once the pattern is set, the wafer will be bombarded with positive and negative ions to tune the electrical properties part of the pattern. And then the process starts all over again for the next layer and the next and the next.
Exactly. The full manufacturing process consists of thousands of these steps. After 4 months of nanoconstruction, a single wafer will hold dozens to even hundreds of these chips. Finally, the chips are sliced free from the wafer and packaged. They're now ready to become the tiny silicon brains in your TV, car, or smartphone. And that's it. This was the final episode of season one. Now you know the basics. Thank you for watching, and let us know what you think in the comments below.
By the way, want to learn more about Nanoland? Stay tuned for season 2.